Sagittarius, it's me, Stormy, and welcome to 2020, which means it's not 2019 anymore. All right, Sag, I don't know about your experience in 2019, but as an astrologer on this side and as a human being who has experienced the heavy second house work of Saturn, I'm going to tell you, I feel like 2019 put a couple of you maybe through the ringer. For other people, it was really a saving grace for you. No matter what 2019 was, 2020, and especially right here in January, is offering you an opportunity for sure to make your own way, to learn these cosmic lessons about finances, about your self-esteem, about the talents that you have to make money and take out into the world to better you. There's the opportunity to definitely get the work done. So I just want to start out this video with telling you that. This is going to be a reading that is a little bit more tough, but I'm going to show you all of the ways that you can work around what the tough areas are so that 2020 can get kicked off just really delicious for you. Okay, before we jump in, if you would still like to sign up and join us at the astrologyhub.com free forecast marathon that's going to be happening January 9th through the 12th, you can click in the description box down below and join us. It's fun. We're going to be talking about 2020. There's 12 different astrologers. It's just a rocking good time. So if that's up your alley, Sag, come on in, okay? All right, let's jump in here and let's see what this month has got to offer. Right out the gate at the beginning of the month, we see that, of course, the second house, the house of money, how you make money, your possessions, your values, and your value, your self-esteem, the talents you have that you can go out and acquire money, right? This area is hot and heavy and busy. Now, something to think about. What we're coming into 2020 with is stuff that you've already seen. You've already been working with. It's not shocking. It's not new. They're all about the same lessons that came from 2019, but across the bridge to 2020, you're able to apply new ideas, new techniques, new tactics, new understanding to these areas in order to bring yourself some relief, in order to bring yourself some progress. Not to mention, as we look down here, I want to point this out to you, Sag, because I feel like it's important this month. With this Neptune down here in Pisces in your fourth house, this is a placement of faith. Your fourth house is not only home, family, real estate, property, but it is also your own internal security, your emotional security. This is an energy that's saying, Sag, have some faith, right? The things you are manifesting, the things that you are looking for are also seeking you, but stay the course. Have faith that good things can work out for you, right? So I just want to point this to you. This is a helper to you this month for sure. Now, as we move into January and the second, we see Jupiter and Mercury together in a conjunction in this second house. Now, this is good news. Jupiter is your ruling planet, and it's a planet of expansion. It's wisdom. It is divine, and it is generous. Mercury is a planet that is also over communication, but of the smaller mind, the details. So you put the big plan planet next to the detail planet, and that is a hustle that any one of us can appreciate. That is good news. It's optimism. It means there is a plan. You have space to be formulating a plan to have, to do, to experience this area of your chart differently. Jupiter and Mercury together are working together for you. And one of the things that I think that they say with Jupiter being involved is, do you need to make some kind of business deal, right? Is there something in your business or business around your values or your possessions that you need to make a deal or you need to have a conversation around in order to make this area a little bit more lucrative? Is there education you need to get in order to rebuild that self-esteem, to learn even how to put your products out online? Something like that. There's a talent and some information could go a long way for you in your self-confidence and to make this an abundant area. Not to mention, if you look at your chart here, right? The majority of the planets are and are going to be right here in this eastern sector and first quadrant for the month, okay? This is helpful to you, and why you care is because when things get east, this is your hustle. This says, Sagittarius, go out there. Take yourself out there. Let's get this information. Let's get this education. Let's get whatever we need to learn to do these areas a little bit different or to keep them going as strong as they are going, okay? Now, you'll further be supported on the third, where Mars is going to leave the energy of Scorpio and move into your sign. Yes, Sagittarius on go. Your actions are motivated by the ideals that you have in your life. What do you want this area to look like? What do you want to be known as? Where do you want to be 6 months from now, Sag? How do you want this to look different? Are you happy? Is this a beautiful energy that would support you in just getting out, showing us the talents that you have? This is an energy with Mars, who's action and movement, and let's go do it. Let's energy where you're having to, or you're getting to experiment with some new ideas, maybe get in front of new people, new content, new education in some way, shape, or form. This is a wonderful moving kind of energy. The other thing I am thinking of with Mars being in your sign, because you are the sign of information gathering and sharing, it could be a time where you're really having to be a little bit more assertive for yourself, Sagittarius, and you're like, no, I would like to do whatever. Because let me tell you, 2019, I know, I watched the planetary energy. There were promotions that were supposed to happen at the top of the chart and they never came. There was money or possessions that you thought were going to be yours, and for whatever reason, something changed direction. This will put a little hustle in you, but don't let it make you angry and bitter. Instead, use this with your East to hustle, okay? All right, when we get to the 8th of the month, Jupiter is actually going to come into conjunction with the South Node. So the 8th and the 9th, I want to give you as reflection days. And it's because Jupiter, being your ruling planet and being wisdom and reflection, is going to be thinking about the South Node, which is the past, right? The South Node has been saying for over a year, here's what we need to detach from. Right? We need to detach from these areas, Sagittarius. In the second house, what possessions, what finances, what whatever have you been voluntarily or involuntarily detaching from? What ideas about money, what ideas about your self-confidence have you been detaching from? Because they won't work anymore. And instead, there needs to be some kind of new union that happens on this side that allows you to be interdependent instead of codependent. This is a fresh sponsorship, a fresh mentorship, a fresh connection that allows your finances and your self-esteem to blossom, as opposed to trying to figure it all out on your own in some way, shape, or form, right? So I just want you to think about this. This is a great reflective day about the past, and especially about your past self-esteem in this last year, and where and why you would let it go. There's wisdom in letting it go so that you can grow into something else that will help you down the road. On the 10th, we've got this full moon lunar eclipse happening at 20 degrees of Cancer. So this will again light up this 8th house space for you. So in the 8th house, the other thing that I think about is the 8th house is about joint resources, whether it's intimacy and sex, money, finances, sponsorships, practical things like insurance. It's the beginning of the year, the end of the other year. So maybe you're doing insurance, taxes, debt. If you've got anything in retirement, investment, savings, anything like that, it'll all fall in up here as well. But because this is a lunar eclipse, it's still our full moon for the month. So it says something has to be ended, acknowledged, or an adjustment needs to be made to that area. Being across the street from the other financial energy, it tells me somewhere in this next 6 months, there will be a change or an adjustment that needs to be made up here. But this adjustment that you make will give you freedom and relief here. So is this debt that you're going to be taking care of? Is this fear? Is this anxiety about your self-esteem? Because when you take care of it here, it will create abundance on this side of the street. So if there's something that needs to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted, including a relationship that is not healthy for you, this will be the area over the next 6 months your attention will be drawn to. Now on the 11th, we've got a couple things happening. First of all, Uranus, who's over here in Taurus, is going to come out of the energy of its retrograde motion and come direct. While Uranus has been retrograde, and it has been since 2019, Uranus comes in and he says, nope, these structures that Saturn built here, these ideas that you have here, they were good while they lasted, but we need to tear these down. These don't work. We need to innovate here. So in your sixth house, you've been doing and looking back at your past in your daily routine, in your beliefs, in your health, in your service to others, in your very happy-go-lucky attitude? Where have you had to innovate and get some different perspective? Where have you had to stop being so stubborn and get out of your own way in order to be able to move this forward? Now that Uranus is out of retrograde, he's going to help bring the understanding of what needs to change, what you can keep, and what just needs to be passed off the scene because it doesn't fit anymore. So you can expect in your daily routines to have different things happening, maybe shocking things happening, maybe new out of nowhere eccentric opportunities to probably make money, share your skills, share your talents. This could say, hey, in a day-to-day living kind of way, we need to figure out how to get online and be independent. I need to have an independence of my health. I'm making myself crazy worrying about all of this financial stuff because the work is so financial, right? This could also be a wonderful innovation for my freelance people, where maybe you get an opportunity that truly you did not see coming. The only thing I would tell you is with Uranus in the sixth house, it can bring up surprising health challenges where you're like, where did that come from? But usually they have a very quick fix. Just as quickly as they've come, they've got a solution or a fix or a cure to them as well, okay? Now, the other thing that's gonna happen on the 11th or the 12th, just depending on where you are in the world, is this Saturn-Pluto conjunction that's gonna happen in your second house. I mean, the cosmos are gonna have you learn lessons about finances and about value this year. And this slow evolutionary conjunction of Saturn and Pluto is no different, right? Pluto is saying, all right, Sag, I need you to die off in one way so that we can live in another, which means the understanding that you've had is not sufficient. We need something else so that we can live. And then Saturn says, and I'm going to mature us and take us forward so that we can achieve. You're going to materialize, crystallize lessons in this house, in your finances, and in your value. So it doesn't feel great. And it can be a little bit anxiety ridden. You're already a mutable energy, which is prone to anxiety. But this particular conjunction that is happening is trying to pull out what doesn't work here anymore. And you've done a lot of learning in 2019, so apply it. But it's gonna pull out what's not working and what you can't travel forward with anymore. And what it pulls out here, the rest of your placements that are happening this month will help to fill this void and show you how to step this money, finance, talent situation up. It's actually a helper. It does not feel great. As a matter of fact, it could feel like a lot of financial pressure right here. You know, you've got this Neptune energy over here. Venus is getting ready to move into the fourth house. Have you had home, family kind of issues going on? This may feel very heavy, but it will show you on this side, what is an action you can take here? What is an action you can take here that will bring relief and learning here, okay? So you do have helpers this month. As we get to the 13th, Venus is gonna get on the move and move out of the energy of Aquarius and move into the energy of Pisces. Ooh, this marker just tried to quit on us. Did you see it? So Venus moves over here into the energy of Pisces. So this is going to light up your fourth house space. Truly, this is, first of all, as Venus ingresses into a new sign, she brings harmony with her. So if your housing situation has been complicated, you've been thinking about moving, anything with finances around the home or relationships in the home, Venus is going to try and bring some salve, some healing, some forgiveness over to this area. I think it is a wonderful energy too to really seriously evaluate if you're willing to work from home. What can you change in your daily routine and at home to also give you some relief over here around your finances? So it could certainly be that energy. Now for some of you, I'm just kind of getting this idea here that maybe what's happening is you're going to end up caring for someone, or you are already caring for someone in some way, shape, or form, and this should help a little bit of money or value or help come to your table to be able to do that. On the 16th, we have got Mercury moving out of the energy of Capricorn into Aquarius. The Sun is also going to come along, and then on the 24th, we've got the new moon happening. So the third house gets lit up. Now this, Sagittarius, is the business. You are trying to learn these spiritual lessons here, but what it's telling you is we need some new education. We need some new communication. We need some new information. It needs to be original thinking that's maybe not your idea. If this area has been feeling stuck and heavy, then what you're doing is not working. You've got to get some different ideas. If what you've been doing over here is working like a charm, how do you continue that growth? How do you continue to communicate that out? How do you stay in business, right? The third house is about teaching. It's about learning. It's about communication. There could be some things happening with siblings as well. And goodness knows, I just told you there could be going something on, something could be going on in the family zone. But certainly here, this gives you space with the new moon and Mercury being here to plant the seeds of intention for some new thinking, a new attitude, a new perspective on the old things that you're coming into 2020 with. There is a level of originality that is trying to come and break through and innovate at your surface, especially around your thinking, okay? As we end this month, I have two dates I want to tell you about to keep you posted. On the 27th, we've got Venus and Neptune actually traveling together, and I love them. They're the Bopsy twins, but they make things so delicious and so good. And so enjoy your home, beautify your home, be creative at home, put out an attitude of gratitude about what you do have, not about what you don't. Just really let it be big and beautiful. I wouldn't sign any contracts. I wouldn't make any big decisions. They are not showing you all the information because they're showing you something very rose-colored. On the 28th, Mars is going to square this Neptune energy because he's literally saying, now hold on a minute, maybe that's not what we should be doing. That square is going to put you under enough pressure to hold on and wait before you make a big decision or commit to something. The square is literally saying, maybe this is not where Sagittarius belongs. Sag, Mars is here squaring this situation here. I do think this could potentially put you in a position where you quit something. You quit supporting someone, you quit that job and say, forget it, I'm gonna work from home. But this is certainly a level that will also challenge your emotional foundation. So if what you've been standing on has just been feeling too heavy, where can we grab a more positive perspective, a positive place to work from that you can stand upon that is gonna be in your best interest moving forward? So I think it's gonna be an interesting month, Sag. I've got all the love, all the support. I'm following this astrology to see all the places I can help you learn and grow and where to apply the resources to help get this second house lessons done. I'm telling you, I was exhausted when my Saturn lessons were coming through my second house. So I got you, okay? All right, Sag, like this video, comment, share, subscribe, and I look forward to seeing you in February and all along the road as well, okay? Bye, Sag.